Hey guys, and welcome back to our channel. Today I am going to be showing you how to make some cold brew. You may be thinking, why cold brew? Why not just drink regular coffee or make iced coffee? Well, this is the best iced coffee you'll probably ever drink, especially if you just like regular iced coffee. If you like with flavors, this might not be quite your thing, but just plain iced coffee, this is the best because it's not diluted, it's really good flavor, and the way I make it, it's super sweet and creamy. Can you call in a picture? Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, you made a nice line. Can you draw me a coffee cup? You want me to do it?
Yeah.
Okay. Here's the cup. Here's the coffee. And here's the straw. Does that look okay? I especially like iced coffee in the summer because it's hot out and it's just really refreshing to drink. I also really like making cold brew because I feel like it saves me some time actually making coffee every day because I can make a big batch at the beginning of the week and then just drink it all week. I stick it in my fridge and it stays nice and cold in there and it's perfect for just when I want to pull it out and have some. I usually drink about a quart's worth throughout the week, and then we drink about 2 quarts on the weekend because my husband is home, and so we drink a lot more. Anna thinks she should be allowed to drink some too, but she's too little.
Papa.
That's purple, yeah. Can you find brown for coffee? There you go! I think it does take a little bit more coffee grounds than a normal pot of coffee or even our reusable K-cup filter. It takes a little bit more coffee than both of that. But the trade-off for really good coffee is worth it. So, let me show you how to make this. It's really easy. I'm gonna start with this big pitcher. It's just a plastic pitcher. Nothing fancy about it. It is my Brita pitcher, but I don't use the filter part on it anymore, so that's just for the lid. Okay? You need some coffee. I'm gonna be using Starbucks House Blend. These are whole beans that I ground myself. That's why they're in this container. You can use any kind of coffee that you really like. We just happen to like the Starbucks, so that's what we buy. You're also gonna need a wet measuring cup, and I'm gonna be using a 2/3 measuring cup here because we're gonna need a cup and a third of coffee grounds. So to start with, pour 1 1/3 cups of coffee grounds into the pitcher. Some recipes I've read would have you do like a cup and a half of grounds, but I have found that a cup and a third works as well, and so it's a little bit less coffee grounds that I have to use, and so it's a little more economical. Next, add 9 cups of water to the pitcher and give it a stir. I'm gonna put the lid on, and then I'm just gonna let it sit on my counter for 24 to 48 hours. This time it's only gonna be 24 because I'm gonna wanna drink it tomorrow. But if I have extra time and I remember to make it ahead of time, it tastes even better if you let it sit for up to 48 hours on the counter before you strain it. I'm gonna come back tomorrow to show you how to finish this off and also to show you what I put in it when I'm ready to drink it. All right, now to finish the coffee. Anna's gonna help me here a little bit. We just need to strain the coffee, and I'm gonna do that through some paper towels and a sieve. You can use like a mesh bag or something, but I don't have one, so paper towels works okay, just as long as you have enough layers so the paper towel doesn't burst and coffee grounds leak everywhere. I'm gonna try to do this with one hand as I pour. So I have the paper towels crisscrossed, there's two in there, in my sieve and then a pitcher that is big enough to hold all the coffee. The coffee's been sitting about 27 hours. Most of the coffee grounds have settled to the bottom, so that's why there's not a lot yet in the filter. You could also use a coffee filter, but it takes a lot longer to filter through. You want to help pour? Okay, don't. Wait for it to drain a little bit. Then you can help pour some more. Now that all the coffee has pretty much drained through the grounds, I'm just gonna wrap up the paper towel in a little ball and squeeze it together with my hands to get out even more coffee. You gotta be really careful doing it this way, as sometimes the paper towels will burst and coffee grounds will get in your coffee, which is not great. So just be careful and stop if it does burst. I just try to make sure my hands are mostly around as much of the coffee grounds as I can. And I did wash my hands. I'm gonna save these grounds for my garden. I'm gonna dry them out and then sprinkle them on the garden. Whoa. You're trying to drink my coffee.
Yeah.
She is begging for my coffee. I'm gonna show you guys how to make this with cream and sugar, how I drink it. So here we go. I'm gonna use some heavy cream. Bloop. About that much cream. And a couple of spoons of sugar. You wanna dump? Then we gotta give it a stir. Can you help me stir? Just give it a really good stir until all the sugar is mixed in. If you've kept this in the fridge, it will take a little bit more to actually stir in the sugar. But just make sure the sugar is dissolved. And then just taste it. If it needs more of anything, just change it. Or maybe less. Maybe you don't like it quite as sweet and creamy as I do. Anna has been begging for a taste, so I'm gonna let her lick off the spoon. Here. Do you think it tastes okay? It's good? It's a good drink? So there you have it. This is my super yummy coffee drink that I'll probably drink all summer long. I'm gonna keep the pitcher of it in the fridge so that it stays cold and is even colder when I drink it. You could also add ice to this. I just don't like it that cold and I don't like the ice diluting it. So do it to your preference. So that's how you make cold brew coffee according to my way. I'm sure there's lots of other ways out there that you can make it, but this is just how I found that it works. If you try this recipe and like it, or even if you don't, let me know down in the comments what you think of it. Are you an iced coffee type of person or a hot coffee person? I just really like this because it's not bitter. It is sweet and creamy. It's not diluted like a lot of iced coffees are. With ice, sometimes it just dilutes the coffee way too much. So I really like this, that it's strong right from the get-go and it can just sit in my fridge and I'm ready to drink it whenever I want. And apparently, Anna really likes it too, huh? So thanks for watching this video and I hope you liked it. Don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. Subscribe to our channel if you haven't done so already. And see you next time.
Uh-huh.
What?
Bye.
You telling them bye?
Uh-huh.